Hello MBBs, welcome back on my channel MBB Ruth, and today I want to show you how to prepare a fenugreek paste, leaving it to infuse for about 6 hours in water in order to activate the mucilage that is in it. This is a long process, very long process, but let me show you how it went. So stay tuned, and if you are new, why don't you subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any one of my videos. I try to post twice a week showing how I take care of my hair, my skin and my scalp using only natural products. So the ingredients we are using is fenugreek. I have two types of fenugreek. The small one I got is from the Indian shop, while I ordered this big one from Amazon. The reason why I'm going to mix these two is because I realized after using the first one that it doesn't have a lot of mucilage in it. So I want to mix it with the big one, hoping that I will be able to activate the mucilage in this two fenugreek. They are different. One is fine powder while the other one is not fine. So I'm actually going to use 40 grams of each of these fenugreek brands, and then it will be a total of 80 grams of fenugreek that I'm using. I really wanted to measure it and weigh it in order to see, you know, to make a comparison later on with how much products I'll be able to get from just 80 grams of fenugreek. So here is the second package. I'm adding my 3 spoons, and then I go ahead to mix it very well. While it is mixing, I am heating some drinking water on fire. Now this process normally takes 12 hours, but I'm going to make it 6 hours because, you know, I have things to do. So the very important thing to do is that when you are mixing it, don't just pour the whole water on your fenugreek immediately. If not, it's not going to work. So what you have to do is warm up your water and then pour a little bit in the container and then mix it. So when you get to a consistency that is creamy, then you stop pouring the water and you let it sit for like an hour. After an hour, you come back, you pour more water in it again, a little bit at a time, please, because if it is too much, it's going to ruin everything. And so when you pour it, you mix it until the fenugreek absorbs the water, and then you let it sit. So every 40 to 50 minutes, you come back and do the same procedure. So with time, you see that the fenugreek will begin to absorb the water, and what is doing the absorption is the mucilage that is contained in the fenugreek that is absorbing the water and swelling up. And the mucilage is what gives that sensation of softness to the hair. It hydrates the hair, it moisturizes the hair a lot. And I didn't know it was the mucilage that was doing this. With the brand I've been using previously, I noticed that after the fourth day of application of the fenugreek, my hair will be feeling so soft, very very soft. And I was like, wow, fenugreek is the one doing this. So after thorough research, I discovered that was thanks to the mucilage. But the best way to activate it is to let it soak, let it sit for about 12 hours. So in my mind, I was like, if I was able to get that kind of result with just mixing it and using it within 1 hour, then 6 hours of soaking is going to be a good deal, right? So that's why I cut it into 6 hours instead of a whole 12 hours. Now I know that this process is long, but I really, since we are doing the NBB fenugreek challenge, I really wanted to try, you know, this method. I read online that it's really really good, so I was like, let me give it a try. So do you see the quantity of water that I'm adding at a time? It is really really small at a time, because from what I understood, if you add too much, it's not going to get absorbed. So it's you have to use it as a tea rinse or something like that. But the mucilage will not get the time or the capacity to absorb all that water. So I'm showing you how many times I'm adding the water, just for you to figure out what is happening over here. And have it in mind that I cut this video in so many pieces, so I'm not really showing you all the times that I added the water. I think I've done it for like 100 times, which was yesterday. I've done it like 100 times. Then every 30 to 40 minutes, I'll go back, warm some water, and pour it inside the container and mix it again. It got to a point that it was so much, it swelled up so much that I had to change the container. So can you see what I'm getting after 80 grams of fenugreek, and I've just been adding water, nothing else. So after 6 hours, I got about 800 grams of product. So it was time to sieve. So I took a stockings. You can take anything you can use to sieve. And I'll just pour a little bit of the fenugreek in the stockings and then squeeze it out. Now, the squeezing out was so simple. I didn't have to struggle. As at the moment I applied a little, just a little bit of pressure on the stockings, the cream, would just come out, and it had no particles because all the particles were left inside the stockings. And those particles left in the stockings, I didn't throw it away because we are going to use it in another video. So this is what I got. As you can see, it is extremely creamy, very slimy, I have to admit, and it had absolutely no particle. Now, because this was just too much for me to use in one day, I decided to just put everything, to section it in small containers. So each container got about 80 grams of the fenugreek, and I got 4 containers, so I put them inside the freezer, because the good thing about fenugreek is that you can refrigerate it, so you can use it anytime you want. You can add it to your deep conditioner, you can add it to your store bought deep conditioner actually. So I got them stored up in the freezer for next use, and also for my mom, while the rest of it I'm going to use it to deep condition. So I'm adding honey. You know, honey is a perfect humectant, and I simply love adding it to my deep condition. I just wanted to keep it easy this time because I really want to see the effect on my hair. So I'm not going to add other herbs or avocado or banana, but you know, I like experimenting. So definitely during my next wash days, I am going to add those ones. So after the honey, I just went ahead and added one or two spoons of infused oil. I think this was infused with spirulina algae, and the carrier oils I used were extra virgin olive oil and castor oil. That's why it was so thick. And then final product was few drops of essential oil, and in this case I think I used tea tree oil, but you can use anything you want, like peppermint, like rosemary, like lavender, like lemon. They are just perfect. And then I mix it with my hands. It was so simple to mix, and after mixing it, the components didn't divide when it was time for me to use it on my hair. Everything still remained united. I mean, look at how it looks. The way it looked, it was already gorgeous and made me think that, oh, this is going to work so well on my hair. So I was ready to use it on my hair. I went ahead and pre-pulled, then detangled, then shampooed, and this is my hair, well rinsed and ready to receive this deep condition. And here it is. Look at this line. This is actually perfect also to use it as a pre-pull, and and to detangle your hair, because it really, really has lot of sleep. When I was applying it, I immediately realized that I don't know, maybe because of the slime consistency, I really had to squeeze the deep conditioner in my hair. I mean, just applying it was not sufficient. After putting it on my hair, I had to squeeze my hair with the product in it before, you know, feeling the satisfying feeling, having the satisfying feeling that, oh, it really penetrated my hair, or it really went through my strands. So the sleep, ladies, is incredible. I will not lie to you. I could have detangled my hair with this deep condition in my hair. And apart from the squeezing part, the procedure was not difficult at all. It was easy to apply the product on my hair. I'm used to seeing my hair change color anytime I'm applying my deep condition, which didn't really happen this time, because fenugreek doesn't really have a strong color. So my hair color remained the same, but that doesn't mean that the product is not working. So I just went ahead and applied the deep condition on all my hair, and also on my scalp. Yes, apply it on the scalp, because fenugreek has very good conditioning properties on the scalp, and it may help to strengthen the hair follicles and aid in hair growth. So don't be afraid to apply it, to generously apply it on your scalp as well. So after the application and a good scalp massage, I covered my hair with a plastic cap and with my deep conditioning cap. And then it happened that I had to go outside. So I decided to wear my beret, and I came back after like, I think, 4 hours. You can see the product was coming out from my beret. But, you know, I had to go out, so I had actually no option than to just put on this beret, which I'm going to wash out. So after 3 hours, I think it was after 3-4 hours, I came back. So I didn't use heat to deep condition this very time. I just left it on my hair and allow my body heat to condition it. It was still feeling very, very wet. The rinsing out was not challenging, but you really need to go in with your hands and squeeze out the fenugreek from your hair and your scalp. So it took a little bit more of time and water. Now at this point, my hair was feeling strengthened. Okay, as I always tell you, the first 2-3 days of my hair after using the fenugreek, I feel it strengthened. Then after on the 3rd and 4th days, the effect of the mucilage kicks in. So I'll be updating you in my group Natural Black and Beautiful, and also on my page on Facebook NBB Ruth, and obviously on Instagram, to let you know if these two brands of fenugreek I used had enough of the mucilage. But it's not as strengthening as a protein treatment, okay? So don't worry, your hair is not going to break. So I went ahead immediately, apply my shea butter, and style my hair into twists. You know, I normally don't go out with my hair in a poof or out. I really like to put it in a protective style. So let me know in the comment section if you like this video, if you're going to try this method, and or if you've already tried it and you want to give me your feedback. But if you've been watching till now and you've not subscribed, I just want to ask you to consider subscribing so that you don't miss any one of my video. From now till ending of May is going to be more on fenugreek and different ways of using fenugreek. As I told you, the leftover from the stockings, I'm going to use it in a very special way, and that is going to be on my skin. So I hope to publish that video by next week. So thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate you. Be safe wherever you are, and as usual, remember to remain natural, black, and beautiful.